Let's go on over to the work table and take these pieces of junk that look like exactly like what they are and make them look like what they were born to be. I gotta change this shirt. Actually, let's just put a shirt over it. That works. Let's do it. Hey, Bad Buddies. Paul Roberts, Artsy One here again to finish this belt. I went ahead and just glued this stuff on. So one of the first things I do is a stress test. Make sure everything seems to want to stay on there okay. Okay? So far, so good. Yeah, I think I like the way that goes around. Let me show you what everything is, and then we're going to talk to you about what I do to make it look like not a bunch of junk. Because, quite frankly, there's some interesting things on there, but they're not very interesting in this state. So, let's go up top and talk us through this.
All right, just a quick little review. Have this nice batarang holder. That works. This is a nice magnetic pouch. It's a little bit messed up there. I'm going to have to cover that up. Some throwing darts in here. I don't know if that's going to be staying in there. There's those metal things. I tried grinding them down, and I really don't have the right kind of grinder. But I thought, well, you know, they're metal. And, you know, they just, I don't know. I'm going to stick them in there. You got to have something in there, right? I don't know what it is. So that hasn't been finalized. This nice metal belt. I was going to put this over it. But I saw this little detail right here and this curve when I was doing it, and I found this other metal piece, and I decided, no, for this buckle, I'm not going to do that. I can make a few more from this piece, and maybe one of the next ones will have the brass over top. This is just some kind of reflector thing I put over here. I'm going to probably let some of that red show through. I stuck that thing on there because it's a doodad just for one of those ace bandages, but when you put it by itself, it looks like it could be something. These are just to make this phone case look different. I realize it still looks too much like a phone case, and I'd like to do something else with that, but I'll decide that once I start to finish it and see how far away I am from where I need to be. I've got this that goes on here, like I said, it'll stay on while I'm using it, and I can easily grab it off. Somehow this apparatus connects into this. I don't know what it is, but we can figure that out in the next movie, and you can just throw this at whatever. So that's what that is. Of course, you have your smoke pellet canisters where they come out the bottom when you turn this. I stuck little things on that have no purpose because each one's a little bit different. I worked with the pieces I had. When this doesn't look like a bolt, it'll look like, okay, that's part of the spring mechanism or something like that. I don't know. And I just had a few of these left over. I just stuck them on the sides. It's going to go around underneath the cape. You're not going to see it anyway, but it's there. If you want to display it, it's just another thought of how we can finish something. Take something crude and ugly like this. You make it more muted and more similar to everything else. And all of a sudden, it looks like it's integrated into this. Like those pictures I showed you in the Star Wars store the other day. So let's get started. As messy as I am, I always try not to make too much more of a mess, so boom! Okay. One of the greatest ways to start on something like this is to lay down a base. Our best friend in this is a lot of times black. Some of these slick surfaces, it's not going to want to stick to. And a little bit of that silver comes through, rather than just having silver or gold paint, that's okay. I like some of the surfaces, and I don't mind if some of them come through as what they are. But we've got to tone them way back. So the first thing I'll do is go ahead and power through some of the things that are messed up. This is why I wasn't so worried about the belt part when I was doing that yesterday. I realized, oh man, it took me way too long to do that for the video. But I just wanted to show you what goes into it. So I'm going to do this. Now the reason I'm going to do this is I don't want to have a spray paint look. I want to mute this down a little bit more. But I don't want to go onto the belt underneath it as much. So I'm going to do that a little bit like that to mute that down. You don't want this to look like a plastic item. Batman doesn't use plastic items. One of the reasons why I use the brush is because if you go really light, it doesn't show brush strokes. But it makes sure that you get it nicely spread without looking cheap. And it'll give you a base to work off of when you add additional colors to it. Additional techniques. I like this red. I like this nice brass coming through. So we're not going to really mess with that. I like this little magnetic clip here. Isn't that great? So I'm just going to put a little bit on that. If I go too heavy on anything, I can always come back with thinner later on too. This is just muting it down. This is great just the way it is, but I just want some more stuff on there. Just barely on there for right now. Clean that brush is what we're doing. We're cleaning the brush on the thing. That's all we're doing. So little on there, it's like dry brushing. This one needs a lot, and I don't care because it's not going to get on the thing underneath it. Spray it from different angles. Come back and get that later. Got a little window there, but I'm not going to use it as a window. It's too obvious that it's a phone case, so I really need to do something more to that. Hey, I thought you passed the stress test. What happened? Okay, guys, this is another thing. I didn't do any tests. A lot of times I don't do tests when I'm working on a video. And I'll do the test afterwards, and I'll realize, oh, this vinyl, it's just too slick. I'm going to do several different things. A bunch of screws. I'm going to screw in everything that we screwed in from behind. And anything like this, where I used hot glue, I should have done the test first. And I should talk this through as I do it, but sometimes I'm just in a rush and I don't. If the test doesn't work on the particular material that you're working with, no problem. There's millions of other things. Now, I usually use these because they're fast, but there's Gorilla Glue, Marine Goop brand glues. Use that for facades and all kinds of things. Very little will fail with that. But for today's purposes, the Zappa Gap is seeming to stick on these other items, so I'm going to go with that. And then do another pull test. It's nice and strong there. So the Zappa Gap penetrates the surface here, but it's like some kind of a brushed fur type of thing. Even though it's slick, the Zappa Gap will go down into every single one of those fine crevices and grab on like crazy. So the question is the other side of this something that'll grab on like crazy? And plastic usually is. So that works. A lot of times I'll hammer in or I'll smush in really well hot glue, and it could get down into there, but I didn't. And it was slick, and it didn't get down into those crevices, and so that didn't bond. This is the way to go on this particular fabric. Every time you work with something different, you're always going to have a different way it treats you, and you're going to have to learn to treat it back appropriately. That's all part of the process. And like I say, I was brought up in the industry, not in the manufacturing industry, but the entertainment industry. If I was going to do manufacturing, I would go a whole different approach. This approach is not for manufacturing. This approach is for movies, costumes, things you're going to want to fool with, and you want to have fun doing it, then you might want to throw it away or trade it and go on to the next thing. So this approach isn't for everyone, but you can make it tougher by simply taking a washer on each one of these and screwing them into the back of anything heavy like this. What I do is I usually put the glue right down the center, so as it wraps around you, the piece has a little bit of give on the edges. That's what I usually do. But if I was going to go on the back, I would go one, two screws there, maybe three, and I'd go one, two there. It would still have the give around the edge. Now, I don't have to do just two. I could go one, two, three, four. It wouldn't have the give around the edge. And with this plastic and this washer and this vinyl and this tough resin, that would work if I really wanted to build this up. And I recommend, if you do something at home, you don't do it in an hour like me. You take 2 hours, and that's where you're going to get your value from. And try to mute anything that's still standing out a little bit more. And give some scuffing to the edges. This isn't necessarily battle damage. If you do it light enough, it's just wear. Giving you just a little bit more of that used in the field look. Indiana Jones, Star Wars, the big budget movies, they really helped a lot to establish looks. The film and the grain just loves to pick up all the subtleties and nuances of a piece that's treated, and a lot of it retreats into darkness. A lot of it's captured by a bright highlight. If you do this to the items, a lot of times when that gleam catches it and the shadow retreats, you have just perfect places where some of the texture shows, some of what you've done shows, but then a lot of it retreats away, some of it gets full blown out. You don't want to have nothing there, because then it looks like cheap. It looks like what it is. So you always want to give it some kind of coating. I was watching a video on Pirates of the Caribbean, and they're always refurbishing that ride. They're doing it right now. I suspect it's because they want to take Johnny Depp back out of it. But what was happening back in the olden days, when there were no rules and people just got away with everything, including Disney, they were using some real human bones. They've painted them so much, and since then, it's illegal, I think, to do that. They've replaced everything, at least to the point of the inspectors, where they say, okay, you're good. But the thing is, they coated everything with resins and different things. This is going to need a little bit of black right there, and I'll rub it off from around it. They say that some of the bones are still there. It's just really hard to figure out where, so they just let it slide. But that's nothing compared to the Haunted Mansion. The Haunted Mansion has more, more real ghosts, you count ashes, than anywhere else. They're constantly sweeping up the ashes, and that's just the inside. On the outside, you can't really sweep them up. You get into the graveyard there or whatever, people bring their ashes. Why are we talking about these things? Well, we're talking about these things because everything is not as it seems. And I love the fact, it's almost like magic. This is why I like movies and television. Because nothing is what it seems like in movies and television. But look at all you guys. You're wearing suits. You're watching this stuff like it could be real. It just entertains. And we need that in our crazy, hectic lives, don't we? Yes, we do. And that's why the movies are so big. Now, me, I had a nice, simple life. In fact, one of the comments said, I like how you take us back to the 80s. Thank you very much for that. Yeah, it was a simpler life. You guys didn't have that. We didn't have to escape our troubles. We didn't have to have entertainment to take us somewhere else. We actually had the time to really say, okay, let's really focus on our craft. Let's really learn something. We're going to make our way in this world. Now everybody's doing that. Have you ever noticed? Why'd you bother learning to play guitar or drums? Chances are you're not going to be successful. I hope you're having a good time with it. How many people can you possibly have that can sing and play a musical instrument and entertain? There's just not enough room for it in life. There's not enough room for what I do. So what I'm doing here is I'm trying to become something different and doing it because this is not my life. This is just the way I relate to people while I'm having my life. It's just one of those things for me. I'm keeping in mind that when I come back to other areas, they're going to be a little bit drier. I'll be able to treat them different. What I do with the brush will affect it in different ways. If I see somewhere where I'm getting a real big old mess like that, I'm going to just say, okay, I'm going to goop you up. I'm tired of you looking like a plastic window. I don't know what I'm going to do when I come back. Obviously, it's not going to stay like that. But I let little things dry, and I come along, and every once in a while, I spritz, too, because you catch a little bit of a couple little dots become part of the texture also, but not so many that you notice it. Very important. I was thinking about doing this with hand-painted acrylic and mixed colors, and I may do one like that because a lot of people don't want the battle-damaged used Star Wars look. They want to have everything's nice. He just got it put together, and he went out for his first night. And I could do that. It's just a different way of looking at things. One of the things I'm going to do while I'm waiting for it to dry and I'm talking to you all on the video is go around and do the tops and the sides. So I'm going to take a little bit of black, a little bit of muck. It's really, I'm creating a mud, okay? Because I don't want everything to look the same. So I'm going to create a mud here. I'm going to go on the sides. I'm going to take that mud. It's kind of like what I'm doing, but a little different. I'm going to rub that mud around. This is right next to the buckle, so that's going to show. If I go too clean, everything will look too good, and it won't work. So, how can we create muds? You don't want to go too far from your color palette. I've already got stuff down on this board that comes up also. A painter's palette is like that also. To create a mud, I'm always going to stay in the same area on the palette. I'm going to pick up stuff I've used in the past. That's a good way to work. Bob Ross starts with a new palette every single time, but he ends up doing that by the end of the half hour painting. So it happens fast. I just think about it ahead of time because I've already done it before. You ready to start our day?
Yeah, I just need to get in the car to get emergency water so I can fill it up.
Okay.
Oh, this is where the magic
happens. Oh, there he is.
Yeah, it is where the magic happens.
Yes, it's just that easy to get in the Batcave. If you're my son, my wife, or my son's friend even, I always say there's only been two people that have been in the Batcave. Zane and Alfred. I'd like to keep it that way, but friends and family excluded. So anyway, they're ready to go. I'll come back in another time and I will see what I've got. It'll all be set and I'll add finishing touches. All right, I'll be back. Yes, it's imagination. It's just junk, but I just feel like I could do Batman-type things. So in a couple of hours, we have a very usable thing that you can incorporate in your costume. I hope I've helped to inspire. I hope I've helped to give ideas. I hope I've just helped to be a Bat Buddy. Because what's more important than that? I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies. Maybe in the next video, I'll try the hoist. What's this button do?